Welcome back to Valheim. My name is Tushar, and this is probably going to be the last update on my base because I pretty much added everything to my base I wanted. So until the Heart and Helm update hits, I'm probably going to leave it as it is right now before I made any big changes. But as you can see here, this inner area of my wall is basically filled up with stuff now, so I'm going to take a closer look at it in a minute. But I built this tower to get a better look over my entire base to see how everything looks, and basically to grab a nice screenshot of it. Because I don't use commands, so I had to build a tower to get this view. So let's go downstairs, and by the way, this tower is temporary, so we'll be breaking it down once I'm done with this. And let's go inside. As you might notice, the towers are a bit different as well near the gate. I beefed up the top part a bit with the wooden part and the roof. And now if we come inside, then we see that there is a whole lot of other stuff built here, and I've got now a nice cobble path. So basically did all the roadwork and the grass and in the inner area, and then the spaces I marked out, built stuff to basically service the main building. So everything in here has a purpose. So the first thing you see over here is this area. This is basically my storage of raw materials. The idea was to have the stone and wood in here, but I've been mainly using it to store my barley. Got a cart over here parked with a spot to repair it. And over here I've got the most annoying workstations that I need to place everywhere if I'm starting to build. So the stone cutter and this metalworking bench, especially the metalworking one, because it uses so many metal bars. So just break it down, then grab it and drop it where you need it. And we've got, of course, a nice big bonfire here in the middle. And why it's starting to rain? I don't want that. To keep us warm, at least. And over here I've got my expedition portal. This is basically a portal I've set for if I'm out in the wild, I'll just grab my portable supplies and then can port back home if I need to. And then over here I've got another storage for my cart, my second cart at least. I mainly use that for my industrial area. And as you can see over here, I've expanded my industrial area a bit as well, including the roof, so I've got a bit more coverage. I've got now my blast furnace, but it's done with dispatch, still needs one. That's the annoying part. If you place 10 of those bars in here, 20 coal is not enough, just barely. It's always one left over for me. That's the last one. And let's see that. Yeah, it still needs to be topped up, but yeah, and ready for the next batch. Still got my old smelting over here, and then over here I've got my storage for the process bars. Let's grab 10 more. Just put a bit here, then do something else, then it's done here. Do it again. Got my spinning wheel and my artisan table, so that's basically your reward for the dragon boss, the fourth one. So I did defeat all the bosses up to the fourth one. I didn't defeat the last one yet, because I haven't found where he is yet. But that's basically the last thing I want to do in here, before the last update I think is going to hit. This is my plane section, so this is a portal to my plane base, and I incorporated these windmills in my wall design. It was a bit tricky to get that done, because windmills cannot be placed on stone, but they need to be placed on ground. So basically raised the ground within this tower to this level, then basically encapsulated with stone. So it looks like it's on top of a tower, but it's actually not. So yeah, you can basically reach both of those from the ball section over here. And like I said, it's important to the plains biome base we're going to check out later, because I did a lot of work there as well. This is my attempt at a sundial. It's not really done, but yeah, basically morning is around here, and then when the shadow hits here, it's evening, so basically half a circle. So it works more or less, but there's a lot of things in the way that cast shadow on this as well, including, for example, those trees over there in the late evening. So I'm probably going to build up this as a higher tower and then put the sundial on top. The farm we've already seen the last time, I think, in the animal pen as well. This build is new. This was me experimenting a bit with the core logs to see how I can build with that, mixing it with the regular wood. And I used this to just add a temporary portal, in this case to, as you see here, Motor, the dragon boss, because I defeat every boss twice. Basically, one for the trophy in the spawn circle, and one for a trophy, in this case, on top of my my gate. So, framed by those drakes. So I tried to find a spot for every trophy within my base. Not necessarily a trophy hall, but incorporated in my base in general. This little house over here is my guest house. So, it's got a reasonably comfort level, I believe it was 10 or 11, something like that, and two beds for guests to sleep in. Comfort level 9, that looks a bit okay. But yeah, some supplies and a base if you want to visit. So yeah, I added some trees as well to lighten up the place a bit, and this wooden bench around it, sort of. It's my attempt at a bench, at least. Sort of works. And inside my house, nothing has changed that much, but I did add some decorations like this tin rug over here, things like that, and strengthened some of the balls here with the iron balls inside them. But yeah, it's mainly decoration and shuffling of the portals in here that changed. So let's go check out my plains biome, but first I think I'm going to sleep to skip to the next day. And there we go, in the power of editing. Let's grab my portal supplies really quick, because I want to do some exploring as well. So let's drop off some of the stuff I don't need. For example this, and I do need the ice, but I don't need coal. Because I used that to fuel all the lights I had here, so I could show off everything in its lit glory. And I don't need the tools either, so I can drop that in my wardrobe over here. So for example, the hoe and the stitch skulls again. Oh, cultivator, yeah, that's it. Difficult. Some potions, yeah, this is the portal supply, so set. Let's eat as well. And then go through the portal to my plane space. I'll show you what I did there. Because if you remember for the last time, then it was basically an island that I raised the ground in and put a wooden palisade around, but it's quite different now. And here we are. And I put a proper house over here now, and I basically built a seawall all around this island. If you look at the map over here, you see that it is an island, actually on the map as well, but I basically raised the ground, then made this wall around it, basically getting the soil as close as possible, and then framing it with this stone border, so it would line up nicely. So yeah, no one is going to get in here. I did get some raids on this base, but basically enemies have nowhere to spawn, so it's basically a raid without enemies. And I've got my dock area over here, I've got my smaller ship doctor over here. I did get some of the darker metal from the plates by now, but yeah, I really transported everything. And basically raised everything here to get some of the farmland going. Mainly grow barley here over here now. I did have one barley, one flax in the beginning, but yeah, I only need barley at the moment, so not that much at the moment either, because I got a little bit of spot somehow in my main base. Just added the windmill here for looks, although I can use it if I want, but I mainly process it in my my main base. So that's just like I said, for looks. And this is, like I said, the main house for this base. It's very basic, just cutting it here with some very basic cooking and workbenches. And this nice balcony over here, you can have the look over the plains biome over there, or the raided death base over there, so there's nothing there anymore. And then if you go upstairs, we have a bedroom with some comfort levels, comfort level 11, so that's good enough for me if I need to skip the night over here. But yeah, not a whole lot of other decorations yet. I still need to ship in a bit more metal because I ran out of what I did bring with me. So the iron went really fast. That's basically because I wanted to get the chimney really high, and I did need the reinforced iron poles for that because it was barely getting there. It's the height I have right now. So yeah, I can. Can survive and live here if I want, but yeah, it's basically for skipping the night, and the rest is transported to my my main base. Do I have in my cars? Only wood. Oh, okay. Yeah, and same concept over here, just grabbing my stone workbench if I need it, and place it where I need to build. But yeah, basically this base is done. This is a base I put a lot more work in because of the more time I spent here for farming and the raiding I do in my my plains biomes that are over here. That's something I'm going to do after this video, I think. Because if you look, you can see that I basically covered this area and this area over here as far as plains goes, but this island over here still got some spots to discover, and some camps over here that I want to raid. Oh, and there was one village of the damned over here. I didn't encounter that one before. It was quite a shock. I didn't expect that one. But as you can see here, yeah, the island really nicely is nicely situated for my purposes. Just off the plains biome, and not too far that I can't. I can basically swim this if I. But yeah, let's cast out and do some additional exploring. Yeah, this is the worst. This is a river biome, or a river that's going through the plains biome, but yeah, it's a trap for mosquitoes as well. So usually I can outrun them if I have wind with me, but if not, then I have to basically go to the shore real quick and kill them myself. Where is it? Where is it? There it is. Come at me. Die. There we go. And now we got a furling as well. Okay, come here. Save me, Meg. Not during the fight, please. Yeah, it's a. Half frozen right now because I'm using what's it called, Frostner? Yeah, Frostner. Okay, here you come. Yeah. They hit really hard. Ah, damn it. My mistake. like I said, or River of Dead. Nothing happened, you see nothing. But let's continue exploring. That was really embarrassing.